Next up, we often focus on how feed prices might impact a producer's bottom line and on how feed quality may affect an animal's performance. But it's important to remember the water demands that come with raising cattle and understanding what your herd's water footprint means. UNL's Andrea Watson is an expert in ruminant nutrition and spoke with me about what we need to know in managing our cattle's water efficiency.
You know, it takes a lot of water, and we're talking 650,000 gallons maybe to produce one animal. Now you got to take into consideration that's the cow out there for an entire year grazing grass and consuming water, plus that calf then maybe getting backgrounded into the feedlot. And so yeah, it's a big number, but when we break it down relative to what's produced by each of those animals.
And percentage wise, where does that fall if we're looking at maybe a pie chart as far as the percentages for that water use, and maybe what are some of those ideal percentages?
Yeah, so some of the data that we've pulled together, it's maybe 50% of that water is going to the cow, right? If you think about her out there for a year, and then the other 50% would go to the calf as they're backgrounded, if they are or not, or the feedlot, really depending on how many days they're in the feedlot, the efficiency, their daily gain at that point.
Where have you found that producers are using too much water or maybe not enough water?
Well, really anything we can do to improve efficiency, whether that's grazing efficiency, so better using our rangelands, or efficiency in the feedlot phase, right? Fewer days on feed with the same end carcass weight. Anything we can do on those two sides really directly impacts our water use and would reduce our water use.
And then I guess it would also, depending on what part of the state you're in, maybe different regulations, because I know that in some parts of the state you're going to have restrictions on how much water that can be used. How does that come into play?
Absolutely. So one real key thing is the type of water that we're talking about. So there's green water, blue water, and gray water. So green water is simply rainfall. And it's important to know that about 86%, so 80 to 90% of this total water footprint that we're talking about is actually just rainwater. The remainder then would be mostly blue, which is ground surface water, typically irrigation water, right? And a little bit of gray water. And so as you move east to west, your rainfall would decrease. And then also it's important to take into consideration irrigation, right? Kind of following the Platte River Valley and things, irrigation, because again, about 98% of this total water goes to grow the crops instead of actually going to the animals themselves for drinking, processing, different things. And so as you move east to west, just being really efficient with your water, because we have less of that rainwater, becomes more important.
And finally, what are some tools that farmers can use to be more efficient with their water and just overall be good stewards in the environment?
You know, it really comes back to grazing the crops, because that's where the biggest bulk of this water footprint is. It's the feeds that they're consuming, the water that was used to grow those. So the irrigation technologies that we have now, whether that's better crops that are growing on dry land to have higher yields, or the improved irrigation efficiencies, all of those things will directly impact then our water footprint for cattle production as well.